Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you that how you can create this 2D DNA animation in PowerPoint 2016. And this animation is inspired from one of the animation by Abhi at codepen.io website. And let's see how we can do this. And for that I will first take a new presentation. First I will close this one by clicking on the file menu and then choose close. And now I will take a new presentation by clicking on file, new, and then blank presentation. Click on the layout tab and choose blank. And you should turn on the guides from the view tab by clicking on guides. And here you can collapse this thumbnail view so you have more space on the screen. Now I will go to the insert tab, click the shapes drop down button and choose an oval here and just click inside the slide right here. Now hold down the control shift and alt keys and reduce the size. I think that much is fine. And now I will remove the outline of this oval by clicking on shape outline, no outline, and blue I think is fine. And I would like to place this oval right here. Now the first animation I will apply to this object will be add animation, more motion paths, and I will choose right. Hit the OK key. Now I need to adjust the path length. So when you need to adjust the path in a straight line, then you can hold down the shift key and then just drag where you want it to drop. Right here. Now I will add another guide here by right clicking on this one and choose add vertical guide, and I will place this guide right here at the ending point of this path. Now what I am going to do next is to replicate this oval, and you can do this by selecting the object and then hitting Ctrl T. Now select this object and drop it right here, and you can see those red guides, they indicate the exact position, and I think that's fine. And I have to change the path by holding the shift key and then just dropping it on the top right here. So let's see if both paths are fine by opening the animation pan and selecting one at a time. Yes, I think that's fine. And here I will change the color of this one. I think orange is fine. Okay, now we need to adjust the animations, and for that I will select both of these animations by holding the shift key, and here I will set them to set play with previous with a duration of around 1 second. And I then open the effect options, and here we'll apply auto reverse and want to repeat this animation until end of the slide. Hit the OK key. And you should note one thing here, that smoothness is compulsory for this animation. If you will remove the smoothness, then it will make a little bit change in the effect. So I will suggest you to apply a smoothness for this effect. Now what I am going to do next is to insert a shape, and that time I will choose line and will draw that line from here to right here. Okay, now change the shape outline color to white, and here I will change the background color to black by right clicking on an empty area of the slide and choose format background. And here I will choose black. Okay, now select the line, go to the format, shape outline, weight, and I will apply that much weight. I think that's fine. And again shape outline, weight, more lines, and here I will choose round for the cap type to make it round from the corners. Let me zoom in so you can see that round here. Okay, now here on this line I will apply another animation, and that will grow shrink. Set it to play with previous, open the effect options window, and here I will set it to reduce to 10%, and that will be only horizontal. Set it to auto reverse, and I would also like to apply a smoothness of 0.25 second for both start and end to this effect as well. And for the timing, repeat it until end of the slide, and the timing of this effect will be half from the motion path, and that will be go around 0.50. hit the OK key. And here is another important thing, that is select both of these oval and bring them on top of the line. Now let's see again the preview, and I think I have to increase the length of this line to a little bit right here. As we have one string ready, now what I am going to do next is select all of these objects, hold down the Ctrl and Shift keys, and drag and drop them on top. I think here's fine. Now start tapping F4 key to repeat the last command, and I will fill the slide with all of these objects. Okay, that's fine. The last thing you have to do is to add a delay timing between each string, and for that select three animation at once by selecting this one, hold down the Shift key, and then select this one and add a delay timing of 0.10, and for the next set add 0.20 and 0.30, and that way you have to do up to the end 0.4 and so on. Now after adding the delay times, let's see the preview, and here you have the animation. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more upcoming tutorial videos.